The Progressive Governors Forum on Friday accused a former national chairman of the All Progressive Congress, APC, Adams Oshiomhole, of usurping the campaign of the party's candidate in the September 19th Edo State Governorship election, Osagie Ezeyamu. The umbrella body of the APC governors, in a statement titled Progressive Politics, Which Way, APC, by its Director General, Dr. Salihu Lukman, raised the alarm over what it described as the diminishing electoral value of the All Progressive Congress. Lukman expressed sadness that the dissolution of the Adams Oshiomhole-led National Working Committee of the APC had not solved the party's diminishing electoral viability. Joining us live is Elder John Egwara, an entrepreneur and politician, and also live with us in the studio is Sam Adelike, tourism expert and social commentator. Thank you both for joining us.
Thank you.
I'm going to start with Elder John. Again, of course, there is another, the way it has been described, there's another type of form of thuggery in Edo State, as alleged by the APC over the Edo State Assembly complex. What's your reaction to what has happened so far?
Thank you once again for having me. The issue of thuggery in those states or somewhere else around Nigeria has always been a thing of, you know, it comes like that, especially times like this, that is political times, politics times. So, but the fact is, where are the thuggeries? Who are the thugs? My word, who are the thugs? Who are the persons sponsoring these people? It's the same politicians. Okay, so we've so far so good. We have counter allegations and talks about APC has talks, and the likes of PDP also have talks. But who are these guys involved in this thuggery? But we also saw it in 2016, how this particular set of talks had a particular governor to power. So why are you against them now? Is it because they're not working for you? Okay. So I think it's time we start saying the truth to ourselves. There is really no talk there. They are all political machineries. Okay. If it's not working for your favor, you call them political talks. When it's working for your favor, you call them foot soldiers. Okay. So whichever way is happening, it has always been available in the political space, especially when it comes to times of elections.
All right, I'm going to move to Sam Adelike now. I can see you smiling. There's also, of course, the two parties have also been accused of being lawless. Right. First of all, the governor for not giving out a letter of proclamation, and of course, to the APC for not carrying out the legislative functions in the right, you know, place in the House in particular. How do you react to these two accusations?
You see, Edo is a theater of the absurd at the moment. And interestingly, it is not something which we've not seen before. They're simply, you know, taking this a notch higher. I mean, this lawlessness and this ridiculous show of shame, because this is 2020. And I oftentimes think about this entire scenario that we are supposed to have a new set of leaders. We should have heroes politically. We should have people that we can look up to. We should have people that students of political history, you know, comrades and upcoming leaders can look at as people that can be role models. But so far, both sides of the divide have not shown any sense of maturity. To be honest, this is a street fight. And like my gentle man has said, there is no one who can claim to be a saint and a hero here. But what Nigerians should be up for right now is a rule of law that we should not be clamoring for the devil and the blue sea or a rock and a hard place. It should be a case of what can we do in the course of this political season that is getting heated up. How can we ensure that even though tempers are rising, everyone wants to win, but how can we ensure that this is still done within the ambits of the rule of law? That is the core question right now. And the governor, who has perhaps the upper hand because he is in the states right now, she also notes that we live in a dispensation in which the federal might can be used anyhow. But even though that can last for a while, because we all heard about the fact that the AGF signed a letter authorizing the IG to provide security to the lawmakers who held an illegal impeachment outside the premises of the House of Assembly. You know, they can get away with this for now, but later on, the law will take its course. These things take time, but we will have messed up our judiciary system, we will have messed up the rule of law. That is what is at stake here right now.
All right, then, of course, back to Elder John. Let's also get your thoughts on, you know, this same question, the lawlessness that has been, you know, accused of, you know, from both parties. Of course, the APC is also, you know, talking about not carrying out its legislative function inside the complex. And, of course, the Edo State Governor, Godwin Obaseki, also being accused of his own form of lawlessness. So, do you agree?
Yes. From what happened from July 17, 2019, to date, the proclamation saga and all of that. See, I'm not an APC person, neither do I choose to follow sides with the PDP. I see things the way they are. You see, what happened on Thursday is really shameful, okay? Like, when a case is in court, the status quo should remain so. It should be maintained, okay? They were in court to challenge that declaration, declaring their seats vacant. So why we expect them to maintain a status quo? So whatever they are doing, both sides, is against the law and it's attempt to be a contempt to law. Okay? But my point is this. If you are a governor and you're actually a technocrat, one will expect you to be more professional in your doings of things, okay? That the other side are making things look funny shouldn't make you aggravate the situation again. Taking construction workers to the site or the complex site makes it look childish and a playful scenario, right? And we have some political commentators saying it happened in 2014 during the Oshomole time. Should we continue in that line? Are we supposed to be better off? So I just keep saying these things just have to stop, okay? And someone comes out and is congratulating the new speaker. To me, we have one speaker, whether it's being self-decorated or not. What happened on Thursday is really, really out of shame. It's a show of shame, okay? So, but let me quickly say this. Is there a way that we can go about these politics in Edo State without mentioning Oshomole's name, bringing the former national... Oshomole is not a minister. It's no longer a national chairman. But why all the time it's all about Obaseki and Oshomole? The game is between Izeyamu and Obaseki, not Oshomole. So I wonder why people just keep putting Oshomole at the front. If Oshomole is campaigning for Izeyamu, as the case may be, he did the same for Obaseki, and nobody queried him. So if he's choose to do it otherwise now, let it be so. But the game is between Izeyamu and Obaseki. Like my friend said, Obaseki has the machinery power from A to Z as a governor of the state to take care of the state. Coming out to proclaim or declare violence against his opponents, my friend, I'm really sorry.
All right, then I'm going to speak now to Sam Adeleke. Do you see all of these things playing out as a sure recipe for disaster, or is this just a stereotype Nigerian politics playing out?
I believe that this is something we have seen before. You know, Nigeria is such an interesting place whereby you think that we get to the edge of the precipice and we're about to tumble and roll over, and then we get back into shape. Just like when the Oshomole issue got to the climax and we all thought that APC will crumble. And then the president chewing that last card, that joker, and then was removed. Yeah. So I do think that this tension will play up to a scenario, up to the point in which things will get reshuffled again. But in the course of this, we are building precedents. History is unfolding in our very eyes. We should be asking serious questions from the judiciary and also INEC right now, who should be talking much more about electronic voting, about strengthening the systems, because politicians are doing what they know how to do best, which is politicking. And interestingly, all of this is not even much more about the interest of the people. We're supposed to be having discussions and debates about moving Edo forward, about productivity, agriculture, innovation, tech advancements.
But all we're talking about and all is, that seems to be lost
exactly,
in the conversation.
Exactly, it's like a back burner right now. So we should clamor for this. Because apparently it appears both men are playing that Nigerian politics of do or die, which is do or die. And may I contradict or try to counter what my fellow colleague has said about not bringing up Oshiomhole's name? We can't afford not to bring. It's like talking about Lagos politics and leaving out Tinubu. That's what happened during Ambode and Sanwo-Olu's period. People are like, no. Go and beg Tinubu. People are like, some are saying Tinubu is not the balance. But come on, we all know what's happening here. So we cannot afford to sweep the influence of Oshiomhole under the carpet. This man has been the governor for 8 years. He has been a former Labour leader. He's very articulate. He's very charismatic. He's someone that has words. He's a wordsmith. He's someone who has that grassroots, followership. And we cannot deny the fact that we even have people telling us that, see, Edo has decided. It's Obaseki. And some are saying that, Obaseki, see, when the federal mind comes on you, and by the time we go and use what we have, then it will become a war zone. But I do believe that at the end of the day, we will get to that point whereby things will calm down. But unfortunately, lives may be lost, and the rule of law may have been thrown to the Tatars, which is what we are clamoring that should not happen.
Now, you spoken about the rule of law. Now, I'm going to go back to Elder John and speak about the AGF ordering police protection for the 17 lawmakers. Would you describe that as partisan, or is it within his powers as the Attorney General of the Federation?
Just a moment before I answer your question. The issue of Oshiomhole again. You see, as it stands now, the Izeyamus camp are campaigning grassroots to grassroots. You need to see pictures. You need to see people be mobilized, right? That's what Izeyamu knows how to do best. He's a grassroots politician. But the Obaseki fashion are following up Oshiomhole's movement and dance. Oshiomhole is a comedian. It's a comic factual. Okay? If you center your strength on Oshiomhole, how to bring him down, Izeyamu is doing the job. You need to go to my local government. There is no PDP there. Know why? Because everything is about Oshiomhole. Now, back to your question. Everything about the AGF is just simply political. He's an appointee of the present government. So what do you expect? He has to dance to the tune of the government. Okay? And providing security or whatever to a set of people whose case are in court. So if we have to go by strategy, politicking, and all that, the APC, they are having it right now because they have the federal power and they are ready to use that on them. And I'm seeing it on your screen right here that Oshiomhole has hijacked Izeyamu's campaign, the APC Governors Forum, crying out. Are you sure they're actually crying out? I think the issue has always been Oshiomhole. Oshiomhole has an axe to grind in this matter. Let me say this. When two brothers fight to death, a stranger inherits their property. From what I'm seeing, and I say this, write it down, we might likely not have a governor come November 12, 2020. You know why? It's going to be fierce. I'm not a prophet of doom. It's going to be so fierce that there's going to be a series of inconclusive elections. So what we'll have is whoever becomes the speaker today may likely take over the affairs of the state, at least for a while. A stranger will take over the properties of two brothers if they fight to death. That's my advice to both Izeyamu and Obaseki. Whatever they are doing, Edo State should be the first. The people's agenda should be paramount. Interests should be carefully designed. Right. To me, I have nothing to gain from both of them. But whoever wins it takes my support.
All right. Thank you so much, Elder John Egewon. And a huge thank you to Sam Adeleke for also joining us. We hope that, of course, as things play out within Edo State, we'll also have you in as quickly as possible to share your thoughts with us.
We'll be glad to be here anytime.